Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the entrance of the official party, the procession of graduates, the marching on of the colors, the playing of our national anthem and Hawaii Pono'i. And please remain standing for the invocation given by Cadet Leatawa Makiasi.
Thank you. Let us pray. Dear Lord, I thank you for guiding everybody safely over here, Lord. I thank you for watching over us as we were sleeping, Lord. I thank you for continuing blessing us, Lord, as we go, Lord. We live through a scripture, Lord. Philippians 4, verse 13. We can do all things through Christ who strengthened me, Lord. I ask you to forgive every single one of us, Lord. I ask you to continue guiding us and the real challenge in us, Lord. I thank you for guiding us through this journey. I thank you for your healing power, Lord. I ask you to heal those who need it, Lord. And all people shout, Amen.
Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, you may be seated. Good morning. On behalf of the Honorable Governor David Ige and the Adjutant General of the State of Hawaii, Major General Kenneth Hara, we welcome you all to this morning's graduation ceremony. I am Kahikina Abulian, and it is my honor and distinct pleasure to serve as your mistress of ceremonies. I now want to recognize our official party. The Adjutant General, Major General Kenneth Hara. The Deputy Adjutant General, Brigadier General Stephen Logan. Community Programs Director, Brigadier General Retired, Mr. Bruce Oliveira. The Director of the Hawaii National Guard, Youth Challenge Academy at Kalailoa, Mrs. Sina Atanoa. The Deputy Director of the Hawaii National Guard Youth Challenge Academy at Kalailoa, Mr. Tamawhaiga Tuitelelea-Panga. We now want to acknowledge our distinguished guests who are here with us today. Please stand to be recognized. Audience, please hold your applause until all names have been read. The honorable members from our state legislature, State Senator Mike Gabbard, State Representative Amy Peruso, Assistant Sergeant at Arms for Hawaii State House of Representatives, Ms. Tamalani No, accompanied by Brennan Nakamoto. Representing Rep. Eli, Legislative Office Manager Sawana Tupua Fanonga. The Honorable Members of our State Judiciary, Honorable To'oto'o, Honorable Costa, Honorable Uwale. Juvenile Probation Officers Derek Sumida, Norvia Shiroma, and Evelyn Mizukami. From Honolulu City and County, Honolulu City Council Member Andrea Tupola, Honolulu City Council Member Agi Toba, Honolulu Prosecutor Honorable Stephen Aum, Brigadier General Moses Ka'uivi, Command Sergeant Major James Jimenez, Sergeant First Class Juan Thomas, and Sergeant First Class Willie DeJean, United States Army. Staff Sergeant Julian Jordan De Los Milagros, United States Marine Corps. Sean Martin of the United States Navy. Mario Soriano, United States Air Force. Neil Bueno, United States Coast Guard. Master Sergeant Kaleo Anderson, Hawaii Army National Guard. Arnell Data, Hawaii Air National Guard. From the Office of Veteran Services, Command Chief Master Sergeant Retired Robert Lee. Presenting the Military Order of Foreign Wars, Retired Colonel Arthur Tulak. First Lat Peacemaker Matthew Telfer. Building Mr. Jonathan Nana, Ms. Z Nana, Home Farm, Bruce Home, and Liz Home. The members of Big Every Time and All G Productions. Thank you all for your continuous support, and thank you for being here today. Let's give them all a round of applause. Thank you, guests. You may be seated. As we began this new decade, we had 2020 vision, taking our 27 years of experience and channeling it towards a strive for greatness. Our 54th class entered the program on January 13th, accepting the challenge to tear away from their old habits and begin a new way of life. And like all the classes before them, they were well aware of the rigorous regimen they were about to embark. But this class overcame trials that no other class had to face. Class 5-4 is the first class to remain on site throughout the duration of the 22-week residential phase. The COVID-19 pandemic grounded Class 5-4, and their ability to exercise change has been limited to the perimeter of this academy. But as we all know, it is through mundane routine that we build character to compound towards greatness. As an academy, we came together as a family throughout this pandemic and committed ourselves to this journey to graduation. Today will be their first opportunity to exercise all the skills instilled in Class 54 that made it throughout their time at the academy. And we are so proud to make it to this moment. We can proudly say that of the 42 challenge programs, we are only one of seven programs who remained open throughout the COVID-19 pandemic. And we are also one of three challenge programs who had no COVID cases on our campus. Placement is the measurement of success for our academy. This is the measurement of applying the skills they've been equipped with during this residential phase. Placement is considered working full-time, continuing education, or serving in our armed forces. The cadets you see today have been fully trained through our three-part career curriculum: career awareness, career exploration, and career readiness. This cycle, we've committed and executed to achieve our 85% placement goal for all cadets who are graduating today. Thank you to those who supported in achieving Class 5-4 placement goal. A three-legged stool is an analogy for three supporting roles needed for long-term success. I believe the success of our cadets is similar, requiring the support of three integral roles. The first role being their family. Parents and families of Class 54, you should be proud of your graduate. It is through their upbringing that has shaped and molded them to the young adults that are seated before us today. Congratulate your cadets on their courage to change and support them on their future goals, whatever that may be. The second role is our mentors. The saying goes, every great achiever is inspired by a great mentor. Mentors, you have diligently communicated with your cadet throughout this residential phase. But I trust you will stand firm in your guidance throughout the post-residential phase. Celebrate the triumphs and fail forward through the trials. And finally, the third role, the heart and soul of the Academy, the Youth Challenge Academy staff. We have worked diligently for the past 22 weeks, instilling values of discipline, integrity, responsibility, and selfless service. It wasn't easy. But we believe that once a cadet has come through the Academy, they are our ohana. And as a Youth Challenge ohana, we will be here to support you. One of these three integral roles, the cadet will fail or will fall, just like a three-legged stool without one of its legs. Together, as parents, mentors, academy staff, we are committed to the long-term success of our cadets. Let's give each of them a round of applause. Our keynote speaker this morning is one of our own, an alumni of Class 6. She returned to the Academy during Class 5-3 as a Women of Strength panel member. She supports our Academy by pouring hope into our youth at the Honolulu Police Department. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor and distinct pleasure to introduce to you alumni and HPD officer, Star Oliver Shelton.
Aloha, Class of 54. I remember sitting in your seat years ago. I'm not gonna tell you how many years, because then you'll know my age. Well, a little bit about myself. I grew up with many dreams and goals. I was a black belt in Taekwondo, three-time gold medalist in the Junior Olympics. I had the main Olympics in my sights. I was fighting and working hard every day that I could get there. But then I lost myself along the way and took a wrong turn on the path that I had imagined for myself. I then took my professional fighting and turned it into street fighting. A lot of people don't know this, but I got pregnant as a teenager, had a baby girl named Star. I got in so much trouble along the way that I became a high school dropout and was lost. In my eyes, being anything more than a teenage mom with no education was impossible. I had no high school diploma and was not going to be a Taekwondo Olympic star. I made a lot of wrong decisions. I tried Youth Challenge the first time but did not finish. However, I was given a second chance at the age of 18 through Youth Challenge. I saw an out of way to make a living and be something for my daughter. Youth Challenge was not only going to give me the opportunity to have a high school education, but also was going to serve as my starting point. Youth Challenge helped me take back my sense of becoming someone. It gave me the desires to reach my new goals I had set for, not only for myself, but for my daughter. I went through many obstacles along the way, but I got through them. I'm not going to lie to you, it was very difficult journey. But reaching the end was just made it so much better. Because I took that step to go to Youth Challenge, I was able to enlist in the Army, make it to the rank of sergeant full-time, and then went part-time. I served a total of 9.5 years, during which I found what I really wanted to do with my career. So I started college while I was in and continued working on my degree. I was able to get my bachelor's degree and finally was able to land my dream job. I was recruited to join Honolulu Police Department and was part of the 162 graduating class. I have had an interesting 13 years with the department. I did intake and outtake of arrestees, did undercover work, also got to do some recruiting for the department, was on patrol, and now I'm a solo bike police officer with the Honolulu Police Department Traffic Division. However, I'm not stopping there. My goal is to be an assistant instructor for the solo bike division, as well as finishing up my master's degree. This is my success story of Youth Challenge. It is my belief that one of you will have one too. All of you will have one too. You have gone through and endured every challenge and obstacle to get to where you are now. To the graduating class of 54, I say this: never let your youth define you, but don't forget who you are and where you came from. Those goals that you have set forth are still attainable regardless of your situation right now. The class I have in front of me today is part of the world's future generation. Learn here and let them guide you. If you do not take anything from my speech today, I hope you remember this, that you are loved and you're important. Regardless of the reasons you attend Youth Challenge, you matter. So leave here today with the sole purpose of becoming the person you were meant to be. This is your starting point for your new beginning. We are proud of you and congratulations. Dream big, achieve, believe in yourself, and achieve great things. Mahalo.
Thank you. Alumni Shelton, for both your inspirational words and your support for
to you, Class 5-4.
Distinguished guests, cadre, staff, and friends that are watching virtually. Good morning and thank you for joining us. Real quickly, congratulations to Class 54. You guys have been through a lot, and I hope you take mention of or listen to what Officer Shelton had talked about. I'm confident that the skills you've learned during your time at the Youth Challenge Academy will prepare you for future challenges. Best of luck to all of you, and remember that you are Ohana. You are the Youth Challenge Ohana. Director Atanoa, I accept Class 54 as graduates of the Youth Challenge Academy.
We will now present the scholarships and awards. Director Atanoa and Deputy Director, please stand for the presentation of awards. One of the traditions of the Hawaii National Guard Youth Challenge Academy is the presentation of the Lokahi Award. This award is deeply rooted in its Hawaiian traditions, as Lokahi underscores the spirit of cooperation, working together, and helping others. As the Academy continues to expand, we continue to grow our faithful partnerships with various stakeholders. This cycle, we have two Lokahi recipients for their dedication and selfless service to the Academy. The first recipient is a retired judge of the First Circuit Family Court. He worked behind the scenes, building value in our academy by giving youth a second chance. Congratulations to Lokahi Award recipient, Honorable Bodhi Uwale. Since the COVID-19 pandemic, our traditional family day had to be altered. Standing in the gap for the cadets' families, this next Lokahi recipient blessed us with their gifts and talents of entertainment. Congratulations to Lokahi Award recipient, Big Every Time, AKA BET and All G Productions. So just as they blessed us with their gifts and talents, they actually want to bless us today with a parting gift for Class 5-4. So BET is going to perform us a song. Let's give them one more round of applause.
Oh, where? Now, that was a surprise.
Yeah, this is a great honor to be here today.
But a blessing as well.
You know, we played for the Department of Defense in Kuwait when... Hawaii was... But to us, we feel this is the greatest award from you folks because of your great future and your great, you know, things that you guys doing. So thank you for having us.
Take it down, though. Take it down. That's it. Congratulations to the graduating class 2021. That's why we are here today.
Yes.
All right. Much love to all the students in the house, city and county in the house. All Louis Martinez, of course. Yes.
Some call good old days.
One of them good old days, just like today, right, Jimmy? We are BET Big Every Time.
Want to say good luck to y'all in your future endeavors. Look back at this day as one of them good
That's
old
right.
days.
That's right. We're taking you
to the good old days. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Come on.
Let's take a trip down memory lane. Times and the pain. Ooh, ooh, ooh. One thing remains the same.
What?
Where love will never change. Yeah.
Way back in the days, yeah, the old school times.
That's right.
When life was okay and everything was
just fine.
Yes. We didn't have to worry about the dollar sign.
That's right.
Ohana had my back and they were gone up in time. Carrying on the railroad tracks. Eating Cracker Jacks and the OGs. Coming over to the house for a barbecue.
Good old days,
you know we had.
Right back to the good old days. Good old days. Yeah, yeah. Let's take a trip down memory lane. Good old days. Go through the good times and the pain.
Reminiscing about the Honda by the day.
I see
smoking time. Back when local Osha was just starting to rock. When moms would whip you with whatever if you got out of line. There was trouble in the world, but we didn't pay it no mind. All we cared about was chase master slippers on your hand. Getting fried noodles from the Mata Pumo man. Trap your brother one day, next day your best friends. Talking about them good old days, the
baby
and
win. Good old days. Through the good times and the pain.
No pain,
ooh,
no pain, no pain.
But one thing remains the same.
Oh,
love will never change.
Yeah, yeah.
And to the old days.
I remember back in the day.
Said way back in the day.
Uh-huh.
Take like a trip down memory lane.
We are talking about the first time.
Through the good times and the pain.
Love will never change.
Yeah. Yeah.
Congratulations,
class. We love you.
We love you.
Thank you.
Thank
you.
Thank you, BET. Directors, please stand for the presentation of the next award. State Director Oliveira, please stand with the directors for the presentation of the next award. The Hawaii Youth Challenge Foundation provides scholarships exclusive to Academy graduates. Please help me recognize the following scholarship recipients. Cadet Yasmin Duell. Cadet Andre Ochoa. Cadet Andre Fletcher. Cadet Asen Leo Soderberg. Cadet Le'ai Latu. And Cadet Trina Wele. Congratulations, scholarship recipients, and a big mahalo to the Hawaii Youth Challenge Foundation for allowing this opportunity for these cadets to further their education. State Director, you may be seated. Senator Gabbard, please join the directors on stage for the presentation of the next award. Senator Gabbard has supported the Academy for many years and graciously offers another $500 scholarship to a youth who pursues studies in leadership or community building. This cycle, Senator Gabbard's scholarship recipient will begin studies at the Windward Community College in Natural Sciences. Congratulations to Cadet Asen Leo Soderberg. Thank you, Senator Gabbard. American Veterans generously offers two $500 scholarships. One $500 to a cadet who pursues a career development and vocational training, and one $500 stipend to a cadet who enlists in the armed forces. The AMVET scholarship recipient will continue studies at the Hawaii Institute of Hair Design. Congratulations to Cadet Maureen Roman Peter. And the AMVET stipend recipient will be serving our country in the United States Marine Corps. Congratulations to Cadet Ho'opili Mana. Thank you. Thank you, AMVETS, for your support. Retired Colonel Arthur Tulak, please join the directors on stage for the presentation of the next award. Founded in December of 1894 by veterans of the War of 1812 and the Spanish-American War, the Military Order of Foreign Wars is the oldest military order in the United States reserved for America's war veterans. In keeping with its mission to honorably promote the military profession to our next generation by the cultivation of military and naval science, as well as the study of military history, the Order's Bronze Medal for Leadership and a Silver Medal for Academic Excellence. The recipient of this cycle's Military Order of Foreign Wars Bronze Medal for Leadership is awarded to Cadet Ke'a'ala Vai'olu Okana'u Ika'uanoi Sabedong. And the recipient of this cycle's Military Order of Foreign Wars Silver Medal for Academic Excellence is awarded to Cadet Mana Hoapili. Members of the Military Order of World Wars live by the motto, "It is nobler to serve than to be served." In standing with this principal core value, the Order presents a Junior Reserve Officer Training Corps Award of Merit to one cadet who stands out as a leader among their peers. The recipient of this cycle's Military Order of World Wars Leadership Medal is awarded to Cadet Trina Welle. Thank you, Colonel Tulak. You may be seated. The recipient of Class 5-4 Physical Fitness Award is presented to the male and female graduates who have earned the highest average on all four core component tests within the President's Physical Fitness Challenge. The male recipient of the Presidential Physical Fitness Award for Class 5-4 is Cadet Rami J. Espin. The female recipient of the Presidential Physical Fitness Award for Class 5-4 is Cadet Megan Gallen. The recipient of the Director's Academic Award is a graduate who throughout the 22-week course of training has performed at the highest level of academic excellence, demonstrating consistent dedication and commitment to academic growth. The recipient of the Director's Academic Award is Cadet Le'ai Latu. Major General Hara, please stand for the presentation of the next award. The Adjutant General's Leadership Award is presented to a graduate exemplifying a sense of strong leadership and highly developed character, who has conducted him or herself with honor, integrity, and commitment by living by a high moral and ethical standard throughout the duration of this cycle's training. The recipient of this cycle's Adjutant General's Leadership Award goes to Cadet Maureen Peter. State Director, please stand for the presentation of the next award. The Governor's Distinguished Cadet Award is presented to a graduate who exemplifies all of the values and principles of the 8 core components as set forth by the National Guard Youth Challenge Program and the Hawaii National Guard Youth Challenge Academy. This graduate is a model cadet. He's a leader, a loyal follower, a responsible citizen, equipped with a heart to serve the community with the highest of moral and ethical character. The recipient of this cycle's Governor's Distinguished Cadet Award goes to Cadet Aiden Lally. Thank you.
teacher.
Congratulations to all award recipients. Let's give them a round of applause. We will now present the diplomas, certificates of graduation, and the legislative certificates. The cadet names will be read by Ms. Teroa Pasilio. Audience, please hold your applause until all names have been read.
Kalila Castro Ocano. Patience Kili'i Moni. Leanna Hoapili. Trina Wele. Maureen Roman Peter. Shaylee Stottinger. Kea Alavai Olu Okanau Ikawanoe Sabadong. Cardian Esseron. Yasmin Duell. Anika Adams. Mehanalani Reese. Mandy Jivas. Megan Gallin. Manita Henry. Nancy Vasquez Rodesno. Evan Etter. Mark Joshua Bismonte. Kobe Welch. Casey Risa. Prikianu Wele. Manuel Satele. Glenn Johnny. Gabriel Tristan Ritoto. Sinai Lewis. Say Wada. Bronson Domingo. Jomari Sampson. Anthony Marks Jr. Daniel Paul. Joseph Connell III. Bryce Manuel. Wyatt Ryan. Andre Fletcher. Mark Rodarte. Chilang Duong. Micah Garcia Lee. Ernest Ramos IV. Mark Nakai. Evan Jarrell Rambalo. Rami J. Espin. Brian J. Felix. E.J. Sillette. Benjamin Etter. Jason Solofua. Laupati Tupua. Andre Ochoa. Leai Latu. Kali Lum. Aiden Lally. Benjamin Makikau IV. Kahale Minor. Elijah Leatawa Makiasi. Albert Albert. Ekolu Hoapili. Arvin Villa. Keoki Mawai. Asen Leo Soderberg. Danny Isikar. Kyle Oster. Roderick Gouget. Mana Hoapili. Nafoitoa Wilson. Ungaitafa Palaamo. John Abara. Ali'i Mawai. Joseph Stephanie. Anthony Marcus Leavai. Jarrell Faria.
Thank you, official party. You may be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, the cadets of Class 5-4 are officially. Five cadets conducted their oath of enlistment for military service. This would not be possible without the hard work, persistence, and dedication of our military recruiters and our ASVAB tutors. Recruits, please take your place front and center. Specialist, United States Army. Private First Class Mana Hoapili, 0300 Infantry, United States Marine Corps. Private Joseph Stephanie, 0300 Infantry, United States Marine Corps. Private Benjamin Etter, 13 Bravo, Cannon Crew Member, Hawaii Army National Guard. And Private Megan Gallen, 68 Juliet, Logistics Specialist, Hawaii Army National Guard. Military recruiters, if you would like to present your recruits with your certificate, now is your time. Congratulations, recruits, you may be seated. Delivering the class message on behalf of
Adjutant General, Deputy Adjutant General, Program Directors, guests, and graduates of Class 5-4. It was January 13th when we decided to make the change to better our future. Before this, we were at risk. We had nowhere to go and opportunities taken away from us. Now, after 22 weeks at the Academy, we become the At Promise Youth of Hawaii. The youth who will make the change for our community, our state, and within ourselves. All the fights, people going AWOL, and the long, intense CAPE sessions, we became one team with one fight, making it across the finish line. After 22 weeks, 69 graduates have accepted and completed the challenge. As we head our separate ways and face the next chapter in life, we'll always be connected. Throughout these 5.5 months, we have bonded together. We're more than a class. We're one big ohana. And just like ohana, we have our good days and our bad days. But most days, we be together as the YCA class of 5-4. The world is tough out there, and surviving ain't easy. But the tools and skills we were taught during our time here will make living life less difficult. Now it's our time. Our time to make a change and be the difference. As our journey at the Academy comes to a close, a new journey begins. Earn. As graduates of the Hawaii National Guard Youth Challenge Academy Class of 5-4.
Attention!
Youth Challenge!
Ready to change our fate, to become future leaders of Hawaii. To my fellow cadets, as you leave the gates of the Academy, be prepared. Life is hard. Life is difficult. Hold your head up, stand firm, and hold on. Change is coming. Thank you.
Yeah!
Class 5-4 will now recite the Cadet Creed and return their guidons to the Academy. This signifies that the training and residential phase for Class 5-4 is now complete. Rooted in military tradition and fueled by symbolism, the past of the guidon ceremony dates back to the 18th century. The passing of the guidon from the graduate to the commandant of cadets reflects a symbolic transfer of responsibility, authority, and safekeeping of the traditions of training for the next class. During the ceremony, the commander of troops will pass the guidon Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the benediction given by graduate Trina Wele.
In these last 5 months, even though we faced hardships and there may have been times when we felt like giving up, I want to thank you for never allowing us to fall. Give us the courage to overcome them. Lord, I ask that you bless the staffs and cadres for all their hard work, support, and dedication. Lastly,
today, best of luck, graduates, and thank you all for your attendance. Distinguished guests and YCA staff, please take your place on the red carpet for our laying ceremony. Graduates, please stay seated until your parents' arrival. As your name is called, you'll make your way to take your last walk before you leave the academy. And also thank you to our band for also your gifts and talents.